It's called Bostrophedon. When you write, maybe you start from the left and follow a line to the right, and then you start the next row from the right and read and write to the left, and then the letters are flipped. So you can really see they're like rotating and flipped letters all the time in the beginning. So where were we? Yeah, I think this one wasn't called Hilluld in Phoenician language. It was called He. Hilluld was maybe earlier. And Wow could be a hook of some kind. The Egyptian hieroglyph for a hook. Sayin could be a weapon. Or manacle. Het could be a courtyard. Possibly. Could be a wheel, or the hieroglyph for good, or the hieroglyph nefer. That was a symbol for goodness somehow. And yod usually or originally depicted an arm. You can see the arm and the two fingers, perhaps. And also an hieroglyph. Forearm. And cap is probably the palm of a hand. Also a hieroglyph. And it's both because these guesses are because the shape, you can actually see that this could be palm of a hand with fingers, very simplified, but also the name of the letter cap, it still means palm of a hand in some Semitic languages. And Lamed could be a goad, or hieroglyphs for goads. And Mem is probably water. You can see the waves here, ripples. Nun is probably a snake, serpent. Could be the cobra hieroglyph originally. And Samek, it's a bit tricky, but could be pillar or the Jed hieroglyph. And Ein, probably the eye. Hieroglyph depicting an eye, because Ein, I guess, still means eye in some Semitic languages. And Pe could be mouth originally, or corner, or some guesses. And Sade could be papyrus plant, or fish hook, perhaps. But I'll refer to it as the papyrus plant. There was also a papyrus plant hieroglyph. There were so many hieroglyphs. You can choose from. And a cop could be a needle eye, perhaps, or perhaps a cord of wool. And resh is probably a head, human head. Very simplified here, because resh still means head in Semitic, some Semitic languages. And sin or shin could be sun, perhaps. And this doesn't look much like a sun, but then you can keep in mind that the Egyptians often depicted the sun on top of the head of some deities, like a crown, and then it was round, like a sun, but it also had the cobra, like clinging to it, or, yeah, so like a circle shape for the sun, and then a cobra with the head, and then the most of the body following the top of the sun, and then the tail out from the other side of the sun. So it could be like this. So the head of the cobra, the sun, and then the tail. And this very common symbol was called the Uraeus, or something like that. Uraeus. The sun and cobra combined. And Taf could be owner's mark. It reminds me a bit of the Egyptian hieroglyph, a circle with a cross. Also this one does, of course. This is a tet. Also some kind of T sound. This is Taf. And this developed into the emphatic T. So like a harder T, or how to call it, darker T. And this more to the front. So yeah, owner's mark, or yeah, I started to think about this hieroglyph meaning city or town or geographical place in Egyptian hieroglyphs. Anyway.